It's called the Sunshine Vitamin. But what is it about vitamin D that is so good for us? And how can we replenish it if we don't have enough? Well, it's something Katie Jeffrey, registered dietitian and certified specialist, knows all about. She's here to tell us more about the benefits of vitamin D. Welcome back. It's great to have you.
Thank you. It's so great to be here.
All right, vitamin D. What is it that we don't know about vitamin D?
Well, first of all, it's called the Sunshine Vitamin, which many people are aware of. So what's neat about vitamin D, it's a very unique vitamin in that your sun, either your skin or your body can actually make vitamin D when it's exposed to the UV rays of the sun. However, as soon as you put on sunscreen, your body can no longer make vitamin D.
And especially in this part of the country, in the Northeast, that's a big issue because we just don't get enough sun anyway, or our sun isn't as strong as in other parts of the country.
Right. So in the Northeast, think of the colder months, anywhere from starting from October all the way through April, it's really cold out, and the sun's rays are not strong enough for your body to even make vitamin D if you are outside.
All right. So you brought some examples of vitamin D that we can include into our diet, but can we take the supplements?
Yeah. So actually, because there's only a very few foods that have naturally occurring vitamin D in them, and they contain very little amounts of vitamin D, really, it's really important that during those colder months that we do take a vitamin D supplement, because you can't get enough just through food in the winter months.
And if we don't get enough, what happens to us?
Well, a couple of things. One, vitamin D is so important for bone health. So if you don't have enough vitamin D, your body can't absorb calcium. And we know calcium is really important for our bone health. The other thing that happens is if you're inadequate in vitamin D levels, your immune system is compromised. So you're going to be more likely to develop colds or the flu during the colder months. The other thing is that it also, if you don't have enough vitamin D in your system, it increases your risk for autoimmune diseases. So think of cancers, multiple sclerosis, and type 1 diabetes.
You also had your own issue with vitamin D. What happened?
I did. Being a registered dietitian, I wanted to check out my vitamin D levels, which you can do. You can ask your doctor to give you a script for blood work. And when mine came back, it was actually on the lower end, not deficient, but on that borderline of insufficiency. And so through trial and error, I found that I actually needed 2,000 international units, or IUs, of vitamin D during those colder months.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's something we all need to do, perhaps.
Yes. So actually, for my clients, I recommend that basically everyone during October through April take a vitamin D supplement, because you can't get enough through food and the sun is not strong enough.
All right. You can get it through Greek yogurt or any kind of yogurt?
Any yogurt is supplemented with vitamin D. So it has a small amount in it, along with milk. So soy milk and rice milk and regular cow's milk has all been fortified with vitamin D.
Now, how much of it do we need?
You need around 1,000 IUs from both food, sunlight, and supplements.
And this one has how much?
That one has around 200 IUs.
200?
I'm sorry, not 200. Yes, 200, no, around 800. I'm sorry, around 80 IUs of vitamin D, whereas a glass of milk will have around 100 IUs of vitamin D.
So you really need to eat a lot of this to get the vitamin D that you really, your body needs.
Right, and that's why it's important to have a combination of both sunlight, food, and then the supplement. And of course, when the sunlight is taken away during the colder months, you need to supplement that amount with the supplement.
Now, what about salmon there?
Salmon is one of the highest food sources of vitamin D. So for example, sockeye salmon has 480 IUs of vitamin D per 3 ounces of salmon.
So salmon's the fish that we need to eat for
this?
Yes.
Yep. Salmon and catfish both contain higher amounts of vitamin D.
And what is this right here?
That is also salmon. It's just in a can. So you can get either salmon in a can or in a pouch.
So you get the same amount either way?
Right.
It gives you benefit no matter what.
Exactly. And then just think of fresh salmon as well. I just didn't have any to bring.
Just really quickly, what about fruits and vegetables? Can you suggest some
of them? There really are none, except for mushrooms that have been exposed to sunlight. So only if it's been exposed to sunlight, and that you have to check on the packaging.
Okay, so you do need to get those supplements.
Yes.
Very good. All right, Katie, we'll check back in with you later on in the show.
Great, thank you.
Thanks for being here.